Hello, my name is Doro. I'm from Kerala. I make videos on environment and sustainability. Today, I want to talk about Dihing Patkai. It is the only rainforest in Assam and is lovingly called the Amazon of the East. But our Amazon is now facing a threat from coal mining. I do want to make a disclaimer. I do not own any of the photographs used in the video. All the credits goes to the photographers. Also, if I do pronounce any of the Assamese names wrong, do correct me. I assure you that my intentions are in the right place. Let's hop into the video. On April 7, 2020, a standing committee meeting presided over by Union Minister for Environment, Forest and Climate Change Prakash Javedkar, this guy, permitted Northeast Coalfield Coal India Limited to extract coal from 98.59 hectares of land here. The meeting was via video call during COVID-19 lockdown. I don't understand what the urgency is. This shows how hurried and unstudied the whole decision is. The committee suggested Coal India Limited to use the permitted 98.59 hectares of rainforest for open cast coal mining and the rest of the rainforest for underground coal mining. The government is clearly trying to kill life on this planet. Dihing is a name of the river that flows through the forest, while Patkai is a name of the hill at the foot of which the sanctuary lies. The sanctuary is home to many rare fauna and flora because of the beautiful tropical vegetation here. It is the only sanctuary in India which is home to 7 different kinds of wild cats. Dihing Patkai is a forest range with a rich cultural heritage. More than a dozen ethnic groups, including the indigenous Assamese communities, the non-indigenous Nepali communities and the tea tribes. Most of them depend on the resources of the forest. With the coal mining being legalized now, their livelihood will be under serious threat. According to Right to Information and environment activist Rohit Chowdhury, the clearance was given hurriedly via video conference without any proper discussion. The Assam government should have objected to the move, but it seems they are adamant on destroying the state's environment and forest. Mr. Chowdhury also said that we are in such a helpless condition that it has been left to college students to start an online campaign to save Dihing Patkai. The state forest department has gone morally bankrupt and is shielding the coal mafia. While the Coal India Limited now seeks permission to mine in 98.59 hectares of land, they have already been illegally mining in this area. they have already broken down 57.20 hectares of this sacred virgin forest land. Only 41.39 hectares is left to be broken. The Coal India Limited has been asked to pay a penalty and submit a mine reclamation plan. But do you really think the reclamation is going to happen? At least some of you might be thinking, what is a big deal? Why can't we plant new saplings in the place of an old forest? Well, it's extremely difficult to explain in such a short video. These kinds of forests are made up of indigenous trees. The flora and fauna here have grown together for hundreds and hundreds of decades. New trees cannot ever replace the old ones. If we were to plant new saplings in an old forest, we would have to find the native species of that particular area. That would require extensive research and tracking skills. The government, which will not respect the sanctity of an ancient elephant reserve, will not definitely go into such lengths. Plus, mining is dangerous. Mining can alter the hydrological, geological, geographical, and ecological parameters of an area. The change will be irreversible. If you don't understand any of this, just imagine, what if someone claimed your home and destroyed it and you're forced to leave? We have absolutely no right to clear the forests. I know everyone is busy with your life. I'm not even sure if we can save the Himpatkai. But I just wanted to share with you the moral injustice that is being done right before our eyes and that we did nothing to stop it. I have shared the link to a petition demanding to stop the coal extraction in the Himpatkai. It is in the description box. If you feel it's the right thing to do, do sign the petition. All we have is a shared online platform. If you wish to save the Himpatkai, share this video with maximum people and get more people talking on the issue.